World Rainforest Day highlights the exceptional role played by tropical rainforests in the world. Among the Earth's ecosystems, they support the largest range of plant and animal species, are home to most isolated indigenous groups, and drive the most powerful rivers. Additionally, rainforests store huge amounts of carbon, moderate local temperatures, and affect regional and global precipitation and weather patterns. Despite their significance, deforestation in the world's tropical forests has remained consistently high since the 1980s due to increasing human demands for food, fiber, and fuel, and the failure to recognize forests as healthy and productive ecosystems. On average, 3.2 million hectares of primary tropical forests, which are the most biodiverse and carbon-dense forests, have been lost every year since 2002. An even larger area of secondary forests is cleared or degraded. The Amazon rainforest. The Amazon rainforest, renowned as the world's largest tropical rainforest, holds a primary forest extent that is over 3 times larger than that of the Congo Basin, the second largest rainforest. It makes up a little over a third of the tree cover in the tropics. The Amazon River, which empties an area roughly the size of the contiguous United States, is the world's largest river. Its flow is more than 5 times that of the Congo and 12 times that of the Mississippi. An estimate suggests that the Amazon rainforest generates rain for 70% of South America's GDP, which includes the continent's biggest cities and agricultural areas. Because of its vast expanse, the Amazon region is responsible for the largest annual forest loss among tropical forests. Between 2002 and 2019, the area lost more than 30 million hectares of primary forest, accounting for roughly half of the total tropical primary forest loss globally. It is believed that over half of the world's isolated tribes live in the Amazon. Nonetheless, most of the indigenous peoples in the region reside in towns, villages, and cities. The Congo Rainforest. The Congo Basin is home to the world's second largest block of tropical rainforest, covering an area of 3.7 million square kilometers. The majority of this rainforest is located in the Democratic Republic of the Congo, DRC, which harbors 60% of the Central African region's lowland primary forest. The remaining rainforest is distributed among Gabon, Republic of the Congo, Cameroon, Central African Republic, and Equatorial Guinea. Until the early 2010s, the deforestation rate in the Congo Basin remained relatively low due to chronic political instability, inadequate infrastructure, and the absence of large-scale industrial agriculture. Although logging led to significant degradation, subsistence activities were the primary drivers of deforestation. However, the situation is changing, and deforestation has been rapidly increasing in recent years. Australiasian Realm. The Australasian rainforest encompasses tropical forests found in the northeastern part of Australia, on the island of New Guinea, and on various smaller islands that were once connected during the last ice age when sea levels were lower. This connection resulted in common plants and animals on both land masses, while lacking species found on more western islands, such as cats, monkeys, and civets. Instead, New Guinea and Australia boast a high diversity of marsupials, including kangaroos, wallabies, couscouses, and opossums. The majority of primary tropical rainforest in this region can be found on the island of New Guinea, which is divided between Indonesia and Papua New Guinea. New Guinea is known for its vast linguistic diversity, with roughly 800 languages spoken. There are reportedly a few uncontacted groups living in remote areas of the island. Although Australasia has had the second lowest rate of primary forest loss among major forest areas since 2001, deforestation is increasing due to logging and the conversion of forests into plantations. Sundaland. Sundaland comprises the islands of Borneo, Sumatra, Java, and others, as well as peninsular Malaysia. The majority of the region's remaining forest can be found on the island of Borneo, which is divided among Indonesia, Malaysia, and Brunei. Between 2002 and 2019, Sundaland experienced the world's largest reduction in primary forest cover, with Borneo losing 15% and Sumatra losing 25%. The main culprits of deforestation are the expansion of oil palm and timber plantations, as well as land clearing fires. However, deforestation rates have slowed since the mid-2010s. Indo-Burma. The Indo-Burma region is composed of various tropical forest types, ranging from mangroves to lowland rainforests and seasonal forests. Unfortunately, large-scale historical deforestation caused by human population pressure has left the remaining forests in this region more fragmented than in other areas discussed earlier. As a result, most of the region's tree cover is made up of plantations, crops, and secondary forests. Myanmar has the largest remaining primary forest area in the region, accounting for about a third of the total area. Since 2001, Indo-Burma has lost around 8% of its primary forests and 12% of its tree cover. In particular, Cambodia is responsible for over a third of the region's primary forest loss during this period. Mesoamerica. The Mesoamerican rainforests span from southern Mexico to southern Panama, with Costa Rica being a popular tourist destination due to its renowned ecotourism industry. However, despite this reputation, Costa Rica ranks fifth in terms of primary forest coverage within the region.
Wallacea.
Wallacea is an anomalous biogeographic region that has a unique mix of species due to its geological history. During the last ice age, islands to the west of Wallacea connected to continental Asia, while islands to the east merged with land masses formed from Australia and New Guinea. Consequently, Wallacea has a distinct blend of plant and animal groups from both regions, as well as a notable level of endemic species. Guinean forests of West Africa. The Guinean forests of West Africa encompass the tropical lowland forests that stretch from the Nigeria-Cameroon border to Sierra Leone and Liberia. These forests have suffered significant depletion due to various forms of agriculture, such as smallholder subsistence farming and large-scale cultivation of cacao, timber, and oil palm.
Atlantic Forest.
The Atlantic Forest was originally spread from northeastern Brazil to the hinterlands of Argentina and Paraguay. However, due to agriculture and urbanization, it has been significantly depleted. Currently, crops, plantations, and secondary forests comprise most of the tree cover in this area.
Chocó-Darien.
Stretching from southern Panama down to the Pacific coast of South America through Colombia and Ecuador, the Chaco rainforest is renowned for being the world's wettest tropical rainforest. Unlike other regions discussed in this post, the Chaco has experienced the lowest rate of deforestation. This rich and vibrant forest is home to a diverse range of communities, including Amerindian tribes and Afro-Indigenous or Maroon communities. Other regions. This compilation only includes the top 10 rainforests, excluding the Eastern Himalayas, East Melanesian Islands, the Philippines, Indian Ocean Islands such as Madagascar, Eastern Afromontane, the Western Ghats and Sri Lanka, the Caribbean, and Polynesia-Micronesia. In conclusion, rainforests are incredibly important ecosystems that support a wide range of plant and animal species, as well as providing essential benefits for humans such as carbon sequestration, climate regulation, and the provision of food and medicine. However, many rainforests are under threat from deforestation, primarily due to human activities such as logging, agriculture, and urbanization. It is crucial that we take action to protect these vital habitats before it's too late. Let us know in the comments which rainforest is your favorite, and don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button.